Viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows the scanning and localization of the appendix, inflamed appendix. Sonographic criteria for the diagnosis of appendicitis include a non-compressible blind-ended aperistaltic tubular structure in right lower quadrant arising from the base of the cecum. An ultrasound examination is performed to evaluate the appendix. You can see the ascending colon. Graded compression ultrasound on the right lower quadrant will reveal a non-compressible enlarged appendix. If the bowel wall layers, particularly the echogenic submucosa, is lost, it is suggestive of perforation. The appendix is a small pouch-like sac of tissue that is localized in the first part of the colon, cecum, in the lower right abdomen. This is a case where the patient is experiencing pain in the right iliac fossa. When acute appendicitis is suspected, scan the patient lying spine. I selected a high power, that is from 7 to 11 megahertz transducer. You may put a pillow under both knees to have the abdomen of the patient relaxed. You will search blind ended tubular structure arising from the cecum. First of all, we will identify the ascending colon. This is the ascending colon. Then one has to scan inferiorly to localize the cecum, and then one can see the appendix. The colon will have the hostra, which will differentiate it from the small bowel. You can say this is the cecum, and now the appendix should be visible in the adjacent area of the cecum. First of all, we will identify the ascending colon, then one has to scan inferiorly to localize the cecum, and then we can see the appendix. The colon will have ostra, which will differentiate it from the small bowel. You can see the ostra in the long axis view. Now you will have to scan caudally to reach the inferior end of the cecum. Now you will have to sweep the probe to do the examination in the transverse plane or axial plane, also called the horizontal plane or transaxial plane. The position of the appendix is variable from patient to patient, so you will have to look around the cecum to localize the appendix. As you can see now, the appendix is visible. The localization of psoas muscle is also important, as the appendix is often seen overlying it. Now you can see the appendix. Most often, tenderness will help you to localize the appendix. The appendix is seen on the cross-sectional scan as concentric circle. Now you will see that inner lumen is hypoechogenic with hyperechogenic edema surrounding the appendix. Now if you scan on the long axis, the appendix will appear in the tubular form with the same pattern. Now this is the cross-sectional scan of the appendix, and it is seen as an concentric circle. Inflammation may occur when the appendix becomes infected or blocked with stools, foreign bodies, or a tumor. Appendicitis is a condition in which the appendix becomes inflamed, swollen, or infected, causing pain in the lower right side of the lower abdomen. Ultrasound can identify an enlarged appendix or an abscess. It is said to be during appendicitis. An enlarged inflamed appendix or abscess can be seen in only 50% of the patients, but I personally think that in expert hands, it may be almost 100%. Now you can see the whole length of the inflamed appendix. It is not easy to localize the appendix, but once you practice it, it looks much easier. An ultrasound is a painless procedure that uses sound waves to provide images to identify organs within the body. Ultrasound can identify an enlarged appendix or an abscess. During scanning, you can apply compression, which will improve the image quality by reducing the distance between the probe and the bowel. This is the sous muscle, and you will see the appendix is seen overlying it. By using the high frequency probe, that is high power linear probe, you can see the tubular structure in the right iliac fossa surrounded by hypoechoic rim. This is the transverse view. Now you can see the small amount of fluid is surrounding this tubular structure due to edema. Now by sweeping the probe, I can see the longitudinal view of the tubular structure. Bowel walls are thin. Both ends of the tubular structures are blunt. By applying some pressure with the probe, you can see this structure is not compressible. It doesn't collapse. A significant mucus and debris is seen in its interior, but no fecolith is seen in this case. You may find fecolith in some other cases. The area is extremely tender, with the patient experiencing intense pain. Now the signs and symptoms of the appendicitis may be seen in the description of this video. You can find other information regarding the appendicitis in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button. Thanks.